Today, we're going to be going over a quick, versatile technique for removing backgrounds from photos in Adobe Photoshop. Let's say that you snapped this awesome photo of your dog Pugsley soaring through the air. Sure, his form may be perfect, but he only made it a foot off the ground. Not too impressive. Through a few easy steps, we can take him off this beach and put him somewhere just as epic as he is. So the first thing we want to do is create a temporary background. So we'll call this a white because it's going to be just a white fill, and we'll go to Edit, Fill, and then select white for the contents. We're going to want to place this layer below our photo so that as we remove the original background, the temporary one is revealed underneath. If like me, your photo is a locked background layer, you won't be able to drag another layer below it. All you need to do is double click on it, give it a name, we'll call it Pugsley, and press enter to convert it to a normal layer so that we can. We're going to grab the quick selection tool, zoom in, and start dragging over the part that we want to keep. The size of your brush determines how much is grabbed with each click or each drag of the mouse. And if you want to change that, just use the open and close square brackets to make the brush larger or make it smaller depending on how accurate you need to be. It's likely that as you're making your selection, you're going to highlight areas that you don't wish to. When this happens, simply hold Alt while using the tool and it will subtract from the selection instead of adding to it. Once you've done a fairly good job of selecting your subject from the background, we're going to refine it by going to Select and then Select and Mask. The first thing we want to do in this menu is make sure that transparency is set to 100%. This will show us how our current selection is going to look once masked out from the original background. Now we can see the temporary white background we made showing through behind. We can see that with only the quick selection tool, we were actually able to do a pretty good job of cropping out Pugsley, but we can make it a lot cleaner. First of all, we're going to get rid of this slight gray outline that's around a lot of Pugsley. This is some of the background elements that we just picked up when using the quick selection tool. To do this, we'll be using Shift Edge, and all this does is either expand your selection further out from what you've chosen or pull it in. In this case, we'll be pulling it in to remove some of that gray. Now, because this is an overall edit, we don't want to go too heavy with it because it might take away some of the information that we want to keep. So for places like the tail, where there still is a lot of this gray from the background, we're going to use the Refine Edge Brush tool. This is a great tool to use if you have any fur or hair that is getting cropped very rigidly, that you want to be a little bit softer, or maybe even try to capture some of the individual strands. All we're going to do is drag along the edges where the fur is present. And as you can see, it starts to soften up. We're losing a bit of that background and it's looking more of a correct crop. And just as with the quick selection tool, you can change the size of this brush with the square bracket keys. Lastly, if you're finding that overall your selection is looking a bit jagged or there's too many sharp edges, you can use smooth or feather to fix that. Just be careful not to add too much as we still want our selection to look crisp rather than blurry around the edges. At any point while you're in Select and Mask mode, you can press P to toggle between what you started with and where you're now at. It looks like our crop of Pugsley is looking quite a bit better than when we first started. Let's press OK. Now rather than actually delete the background around Pugsley, we're going to mask it out. So with our selection still active, you can do that by going to your Layers menu and pressing Add Layer Mask. And as you can see by moving this layer around, Pugsley is now separate from his original background. Now the last step is an optional one. If you think there are a couple problem areas that you want to clean up, you can click on the layer mask in your layer panel, and you can actually go into there and either add or remove some of the original background. For Pugsley, I might decide that I actually want to keep some individual strands of fur by his chest. So I can grab the paintbrush tool, grab white, and just start to paint those back in on my layer mask. If I add something that I don't want, I could just switch to black and remove it. And if at any point I want to preview the layer without my mask, so the original photo, I can shift click on the layer mask and see it. Now Pugsley is cleanly cropped from the original background, and we can place him somewhere where his amazing jumping ability can truly be appreciated. If there's anything that we want to change at this point, we still can. In the case of Pugsley, I'm going to go back and select a mask and make a couple little tweaks just to make this perfect. And with those final changes, we're all done. And if you want an easier and faster way to remove backgrounds from photos, check out Trace by Sticker Mule. With Trace, you can instantly remove the background from any photo for free. Then you can download the photo or use it to order custom stickers, magnets, coasters, and more. Try it for free at stickermule.com/trace. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.